Okay, so we've had
there's small, but they really
windy few days, and the wind.
Oh look, you've got rabbit. This is rabbit fur.
Yeah. The wind.
The rabbits
has
come in.
Torn.
Well, they don't like that much radishes, though. They don't like
the leaves of the
radishes.
No.
They don't.
Have been in our garden, and they have literally shredded the fleece, and they've been eating at our produce. You can see the mess that they've made. Look what they've done. Look what the wind has done to our fleece. It's on the fence. But anyway, it's clean up day today, because we're at the end of the season now. So we've got some friends that have come, the Eccles family have come to help us just clean up the garden. So there's a lot of work to be done. We have to get beds prepared now in preparation for the spring. And we're not going to be using fleece next year, because as you can see, the deer are just having a jolly with our fleece. You can see their hoof marks. You can see here where this is a hoof of a deer, and they've literally just scratched along looking for the produce underneath. So this is a fail. We are not using this next year at all. So what are you doing today?
We're pulling up the hoops to tidy up for next season.
Okay.
Good tidy up. Prepare. Preparation is very important.
It is. What are you up to?
I was originally looking for tools, and then I found this string. If I can salvage it, I might be able to spool it up.
These hoops can come out as well, actually. These
can they?
Okay.
It's amazing how the grass is clamping down on the string. I keep thinking there's a peg there.
I'm not sure we're actually going to use it next year.
Okay.
Well, thank you for your help.
You're welcome. Enjoy the wet grass, because they love wet grass, you know.
Yeah, that's a lot of soil for you, brother. They're tiny little ones, aren't they? Oh dear.
The tomatoes will definitely be for next season.
Yeah.
Right, take out the white poles.
They've all finished now, and the deer ate those too. Hey, that was a bit disheartened, I think, about these deer.
Oh, yeah. Well, such is life.
Rabbits maybe.
Mm. And they don't like them, so they put them, they just leave them there.
We do have some radish here growing, as you can see.
It's hurt.
And it's hard.
It's fun though.
It's good. Let's go and see what my mum's doing. Having fun?
I'm trying.
Are you pleased with your crop?
Yeah, radishes came up good.
Lovely.
Radish. Yeah, they're not bad. They're not bad.
So you're saying there's lots of rabbit fluff?
Yeah.
Did you see it?
Yeah.
Here. We said no animal inputs.
No animal inputs.
Except for rabbit fluff.
And rabbit poo. And deer poo.
Oh, great. We're doing well, aren't we? Well, they're removing our field decor, which is a fleece that landed on the fence when we had fierce winds the other day. It must have been Hurricane Ophelia. It blew our fleece to smithereens.
Is it a blog?
A vlog.
It's V plus log.
Okay,
log.
This is hard, but not as back-breaking as
this. Is this electric, Mummy?
It is, but I don't think it's plugged in. I don't think it's plugged into anything.
Wait,
are you having fun in the back there, Denari?
Huh?
Are you having fun in the back there?
Not really.
That's why I chose him to work there.
Is it?
No.
Wait, this used to be an electric fence.
It did. They used to have ponies here.
Okay.
We should have that for the deer.
Yeah.
Jolt them back into the forest.
Are you allowed to jump over it to get to that one?
Go, don't jump over, go under the barbed wire, but over the other fence.
I know,
so
but
the
other
one.
And the other side.
Yeah, but there's barbed wire there too.
Yeah.
Use your brute muscle force.
Come on, Anaya.
You can help.
Yeah.
Go under the barbed wire.
I thought I wasn't in the dike. I need to find out this area deeper than where I was.
Oh, there's another fence down here. Come on. Do you want to go first or shall I? I'll go first then, so I die. And if I die, then you don't come. Simple as that.
Just check if it's me.
That's
Augie!
I'll admit.
Cool.
Augie.
It's a bit Naya.
Do you want to come or?
That is not a fucking knife, K-Dub.
What is that, K-Dub? What are you, where are you going with that?
Good
question. Can you climb over here, Kevin? Get over there and unhook and pull.
Unplug and pull. Be careful with the barbed wire.
Oh my
Should
goodness.
I go over there and reach the other one?
Well, may look a red tick.
Is it?
Yeah.
No, they're not ticks.
Yeah.
No, they're those
no,
little...
No, it's not the spiders, maybe I can see it.
How do you know?
I want to see. I've never seen a tick.
This one isn't, this one isn't a spider.
So what is it?
Okay. I'm sure it's those little red spider things that you get.
No, it isn't.
Okay.
You're not gonna kill it.
Yeah, it needs to be.
I'm not going there.
You're not going there. Mm-hmm. Why are you not going there?
Because it must be deep.
It's too deep.
I'm not going there now.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, I might be able to go get it.
What are you thinking, Abby? I can see a lot of thought in that mind of yours.
Turns out Denaro's in a weird situation. Mm-hmm. Because he's gonna have to get the fence from behind this.
Area.
This is a rowan bush. It's actually more like a tree.
Oh, I see.
I'll find out then.
Yeah, it doesn't quite look like a tree. I'm just thinking, how could I get inside and then untangle the other end? Is it accessible, Caleb?
Yeah and no.
Yes and no, he says. Easiest thing to go into the neighbour's garden.
Okay.
To go into the neighbour's field through the entrance.
Yeah, though.
Where?
It's quite long.
The grass
isn't
is cool.
No,
it's
quite
good to go.
I'm actually trying to get to this place.
I know what I'll do. Yeah.
A puzzle that needs to be figured out.
What I'll do is just go.
You got to go all the way out of this field.
One of the challenges is the barbed wire, which seems to be everywhere. Be careful carrying around that knife though, Caleb. Don't run with the knife!
It can't be closed, it's a kitchen knife.
Oh, I see.
Well, that's one of the benefits of a pocket knife. Something just flew onto my cheek.
Tick. Why are they called ticks?
Are you coming out from there? I don't know why they're called ticks.
I just got hooked.
Be careful. Don't get hooked.
Don't get hooked. Nice pun.
So that is what Caleb's talking about. I see why they're going around the other side. This is too dangerous. I tell you, that's like a cave down there.
It's not
Wait.
Deep.
It's not deep because you're tall enough.
They're coming. Can you see
Poor
them?
Caleb almost sank.
Oh, bless him.
She's skipping through the bushes. With the grass.
Rude.
I thought that was a
hole. She looked like the little girl from Little House on the Prairie.
Are they ticks?
Well, it's too late now. I think if they are, you...
They're covered in your cupboard.
Yeah,
room.
Where?
Covered in. We'll check after, dear.
I hope so. There's Caleb.
Here comes Caleb.
Covered in ticks.
Don't kill yourself. What was that?
It's in his hair. It's in his hair. In his nose.
Aren't you going to pull it out?
Pull it from your... That's it.
Kevin, you need to go over there. Caleb. Caleb.
Yeah.
You need to go over there because that's what's stopping it. That knot.
I have an idea. If I stay where you are, Denaro, and you jump in the big old hole, since you say it's not too deep, then you might be able to untwist it, unravel it.
Yeah, it was a tick, mummy.
Yeah.
I could see it had six legs.
Where's
it was like, but it was like red. It had like red legs and dark red body.
Really?
I'm scared now.
But Cape killed it and then like dissolved. Because it's like, it's just like wet.
Yeah.
over there now. No legs, no nothing. Because you went like that, cut. It's like,
we've got it.
Disappeared.
You got it? Well done.
You guys, I'll take it over.
Go on.
Is that a tick? Every 2 minutes I hear, is that a tick? Is that a tick?
I don't want to die.
Is that a tick?
Tick!
Tick!
Go away, you gross creatures.
Caleb's going to get caught. He's going to be hanging.
Careful, Caleb. It's barbed wire. You're going to get hooked.
Rusty barbed wire.
I know.
Well, why are you there? Look, you've just
ripped it. Oh, hey, Anaya. You're a bit late. It's all over.
It's camouflage.
Anaya, quick,
she's camouflage.
You have to run through it or you'll get a tick. Go, Anaya. Come on.
That took a bit long.
Yeah, don't be mean, because you didn't have the guts to come around.
I didn't even realise she'd gone with
Anaya.
You.
Run.
Bless her.
Just run.
I was saying, I ran
there
too.
Michelle. If this was the train in my wedding dress, this would be a wedding disaster.
Come on.
Could you imagine? It'd be hashtag fail.
I know.
Okay. I guess we're not going to come. Oh my god.
I know what that is. Okay. Deep part.
That was a high pitched squeal, wasn't it?
You have to run. That's what I did.
When
I ran
come
through
out,
it.
Came out about
you'll
there.
Be fine. So I run to you then.
Alright then. Yay! Let's watch me die.
I'm scared of going through there, the bog again. It's
I think
so
you're
going
to need to go back that way because of the barbed wire.
But I just went over.
But I managed
so
to go through.
Back.
Go on, yeah, creep your way back there.
I'm not going through there again.
That's what I'm thinking.
Sis?
No, don't climb over.
I don't want to go back there. There's a big ditch
Do
there.
You know which way to go,
it
Anaya?
It went down in. Is that strong?
Huh?
No. Caleb managed.
You don't.
He's lighter than you. I don't think it's a good idea. Just go back.
Okay.
Please. Yeah, go back with Anaya because she doesn't know the way.
I'm gonna fall back in the ditch again.
Well, do you remember where it was?
I do, but it's scary.
If you remember right where there. You came from, you can then.
Oh, there she goes.
Learn from your mistakes.
Oh, I love it.
Go,
run. Go on, Anaya, run.
Run.
All right. Done.
Okay, boys, help with this, please.
Nah, everyone else can do it. I'm gonna relax.
Denari.
Get the recliner up in the living room. Put it right here. I'll lean back in the sun to get my vitamin D.
Oh yeah, we should have
more like a sixth of it.
Oh yeah, because there's no vitamin D here.
All right, you're clear.
Yeah. Thank you.
Done.
Well done. 50p.
Yeah.
What for sitting in your relaxed recliner chair and soaking up the zero vitamin D?
Police should be up there.
That's right, so
yeah.
Get one side, Denari.
How are you going to both carry this?
Maybe
so
one get one end and the other get the other, perhaps.
You have to just rack up in such a way your feet don't get caught in the loose ends, isn't it?
And if you do, you fall into this lovely fluffy stuff.
Lovely. It's better than falling into a pile of mud, isn't it?
Where are we taking it?
Up to the top.
Where the other fleece is.
Oh, I'm in the way, aren't I?
Yeah,
oh, thank
you. She
has
her wedding dress on.
Well, maybe it should be Denari, so that won't be right.
Welcome back.
Yeah. Welcome back. Let's check you over and make sure there's no ticks. Let's see. I think you're safe. Let me see your hands. Turn them round. Tick free. Let's go.
I don't think I have any.
You're pretty much wrapped up.
I think so.
With black clothes on.
Yeah, you'd be able to see them in the dark.
Will I? I don't see anything. I can't look down there.
You should buy a pink coat.
Then you can see them.
Oh, I didn't think of that.
Buy a pink coat.
Or white. You can definitely see it on white. Mommy, I was lost.
Can I hit my hand?
Where are you?
Look, Anaya, you tried.
We had a lot of fun over there.
Where?
But they got all the fleece out.
Good.
They had to go around the other side.
Enjoy standing.
It was a challenge.
Yeah.
Ticks, barbed wire, all sorts. Deep bogs, pits.
Ticks, ditches, high squeaks.
Yeah, high squeaks coming from Abby.
You went Alicia.
She nearly fell into the bog.
It was me.
Oh, was that you?
Yeah.
And Abby, I think both of you. Mm. Yeah.
And then me and Denari carried up all the fleece to this big pile.
So we got it all out the fence.
Right, we're done.
So,
Okay, we found something in the garden. Toad alert.
Yes, she is, of course.
Where is it?
Right here. It's a perfect environment for it.
There's been tons of toads here.
Nice and damp.
Oh yeah,
he's
the best. You've got the best.
I see.
He's got three fingers.
Oh look at it.
Right now, let's eat him. So eat him.
You want to eat? Bite his head off first.
I'm Bear Grylls, and we've got a toad here. Let's eat it.
Some people look at that. And
leave
say,
it.
They say, ooh, that's gross.
He's only got, he doesn't have a leg though.
Oh yeah,
he doesn't.
Maybe he's one that got caught in the lawnmower.
I don't think so. This doesn't look like him.
No, but there were a few, weren't there?
Look at it.
When we were mowing, he might have got his leg cut off.
Yeah, but I think there might be a birth defect because it doesn't look like, yeah, I don't know.
I wonder if this frog has three sets of eyelids. You know, some animals.
Yeah, I think it does. One for the.
Yeah, it does.
One to work like a visor, you know?
Yeah.
It's quite clever with it having a back leg missing. Did you show the camera the back leg missing?
No, Lily.
I like frogs.
Hop, froggy. Show them the leg that's missing. Look at that. It's a full amputation. The surgeon must have done a good job.
I want that one.
See?
Yeah.
I don't like that.
That's amazing. The fact that it's still living.
Look at it. Look at the skin. It looks like it was born that way. Because I don't know how the skin composes. No, Lily, you're dangerous.
No, she's not.
Be calm.
But you can't have it, darling. Either way.
Do you like frogs?
It's got dry skin, though.
How does it feel?
It's not like wet like frogs, because frogs, their skin is like wet. This one's like dry. Like a snake.
Oh wow. Look at how the skin pulls when I touch it.
I like it.
Yeah, it's strange,
it,
isn't it?
Yeah. I like it.
Let's see if it wants to hold on to me. Oh my, it feels so weird. Oh, the poor guy wants to be released. Would you ever bite me if you wanted to? Just the way how he's gripping. Ah, it's ticklish. Sorry, mate. I gotta hold you by your belly.
That hurt him.
No, Lily.
I want to hold him.
Let's just pray when we put the froggy back that Jesus will look after it and that it'll get nice and wet again like a frog should be, huh?
You're touching its eye, Lily.
Look what happens when you do that. Can you see how that eyelid goes up?
Mm.
You've seen how that eyelid goes up when I touch its eye? Mm. Very clever. The thing is, it's moving so much, I have to hold on to it, otherwise it would hop out of my hands.
Mm.
Cutie. Right, where did you find?
I want to hold it.
Let her have a little hold. If it jumps out, it doesn't matter. It will find somewhere to go.
Well, you can give it to her on top of the area where it was.
Give it to her over the area where it can jump.
Yeah.
Oh, that's really weird. Oh.